There are so many benefits of coming out and doing the year-long prac. You're seeing school from before the students arrive the year, you're interacting with the peers, you're meeting the people, you're meeting your colleagues, you're participating in outside school activities like the discos and the sports carnivals, and you're basically getting to know the schooling community, which helps with prac. And yeah, you get to see the other side of teaching. It's not all about implementing the programs. There's dealing with student behaviours and all kinds of things. But yeah, the year-long internship is very beneficial. We are doing some math rotations today. Okay, we've got the laptops to use. We're going to have two stations that have laptops. Hands up who gets to the section on beat the clock in the E column and has a bit of trouble with it. Meh. I know some people mark it, some people look at it and get a bit scared from it. We had our ones, tens, hundreds and thousands, and I had 28 times 100, 28. Where would that number go in here? Just the number 28, just 28. Ellie? Without using the sum yet, just that number. If you just saw 28, where would you place the 2 and the 8?
2 in the thousands, 8 in the hundreds.
No, without doing the sum. So if you just saw that number, where would the 8 go?
The 8 would go in the ones and the 2 would go in the tens.
And the 2 would go in the tens. When we multiply it by 10, or in this case 100, we move them two spaces because there are two zeros. So the 2 would come over here, the 8 would go here, and these two, we would just carry down our zeros. Does everybody understand?
Yeah.
Yes. All right, so we're going to have plenty of activities today to practice this new skill. Today's lesson was based on encouraging the students to use their activities and skills in developing their multiplication of larger sums with sums with like zeros in them, so 100 times 20 or 2 times 200 or going up in those larger ones, and basically allowing the students to see that they can just carry the zeros over and the sums don't then look so daunting. So we'd been working on place value in the classroom, and we'd been using a resource, a game called Beat the Clock, where the students are able to work through columns of multiplication specified, so 6 times tables, 3 times tables, and finally there's an E column which has those larger ones. Today, on one set of laptops, you will be going through these 4 here as practice. Okay, you're just practicing the skill. You're going to be using your own individual Study Ladder account and just practicing. Students have their own individual logins, and the teacher also has their own individual login as well, and the students go through, they do their things, they do the activities, and often there are assessment pieces on there, so the students can do these assessment pieces then later on after the lesson. So you've been monitoring, you can assist the students going through later after the lesson, after school. You can log in on your teacher login and you're able to see the students' results. So there's an assessment site and it will come up, it will show the students' names, it will show their results, and it will show the task. You set the tasks, you can swap them around, you can do different abilities, and different students that hop on will see different ones on their individual logins. So Study Ladder is really good for that, and yeah, it frees you up with being able to assist the students, monitor, and not having to be pen and paper assessing at the same time. Remember, the first group on the older laptops are doing this row here only, just practicing through the skills. If you get time and you've done them all, go back and practice again, because your next rotation is going to be this one here, where you only do that and then you do your test. Choosing digital resources is always something that's quite easy. It is something that students are engaged in. They really are. They enjoy using digital resources, so integrating the laptops and things like the smart board always have students' interest straight away. They, using the smart board, the students are able to come up, play the games, press the buttons. It's all interactive. They're doing something. They're not listening to the teacher talk. They're able to do it themselves.